Okay, I think we start. Okay. After all the nice things that have been said about me this morning, the best thing I could do is to keep silent. Thank you. It would really, everything I say will be worse. And anyway. So the pleasure of research in AI. The main thing is the pleasure of people that work in AI. And it was really a pleasure to work with people. Without them, it wouldn't have been the same. I mean, you cannot have just the intellectual pleasure if the people that you have around are not pleasant. You don't enjoy staying with them. And I felt this all the time, and I felt it so deeply these days, you can't imagine. So, thank you to all. Well, I should talk about each of you, but we don't have time, so I put it in this way. But talking about friendship, Yesterday it was a long day, you know, all the thing. There was this honor in the morning. And so I came home, it was nearly midnight. And then I checked on the phone, and there was a friend of mine from Trieste, who has nothing to do with this. I told him about this honor and Aquila di San Venceslao, Eagle of San Venceslao, and he sent me this. This is his picture. Okay, so just briefly, because some of you were there in the morning. I wanted just to read the beginning, because I think, of the acceptance speech. It's in Italian. Oh, this talk will be half in English, half in Italian. More or less every second word will be in the other language. Ringrazio l'assessore Ferrari e la Giunta per il grande onore riservatomi. E ringrazio anche per le parole di chi è intervenuto. Accetto l'Aquila solo in quanto la intendo data a tutto quello che noi continuiamo a chiamare IRST. È un gruppo eccezionale di persone che hanno saputo portare l'Istituto da zero alla posizione importante in cui si trova nel panorama internazionale. Alcuni sono trentini, molti altri sono venuti da altri posti per sviluppare le loro idee e il loro lavoro a Trento. Tra questi Paolo Traverso, che mi ha pregato di non ripetere, ma lo voglio ripetere, un direttore di straordinaria qualità nella ricerca e anche nel rapporto con il territorio, sicuramente migliore di quello che lo fossi stato io. La provincia di Trento ci ha dato una grande opportunità investendo in questo nostro settore di ricerca, intelligenza artificiale, e desidero qui citare anche il settore dei microsistemi e materiali. Penso sia un'interpretazione dell'autonomia particolarmente virtuosa il cercare di fare qualcosa in più rispetto alle altre aree del paese e mettere a disposizione l'esperienza, anche accettando di non essere in completo controllo di quello che fanno i ricercatori. I ricercatori infatti hanno due padroni, come a Lecchino, chi mette i fondi e la comunità scientifica internazionale, ma se la ricerca è di qualità e con buoni indirizzi strategici, chi mette i fondi viene ripagato non solo in immagine. Del resto la ricerca ha senso solo a livello massimo, in competizione e in collaborazione con i migliori. Se uno pensa esclusivamente alle ricadute a breve, essa in poco tempo tende a essere un investimento buttato. Per questo desidero, vabbè, bla bla bla. Adesso non vado avanti con questo, ma volevo farvi sentire questo. Ok, back to English. For a while, then I switch back to Italian. The title, yes. The title, why this title? Of course, it's an homophone, AI, more or less. I remember the times when people were hiding artificial intelligence. This institute was meant to be an institute of artificial intelligence. And there was a phase that from above they tried to say it was artificial intelligence, but advanced informatics, which in Italian the word advanced has two meanings. One is advanced, like in English, the other one is left over. And now everyone speaks about artificial intelligence, and I don't feel so much at ease, I must say. I like it more when it was a bit at the fringe and we were exploring unknown lands. So now, I'm not so proud to be an artificial intelligence at this moment. It's better to hide it a bit. But still, I'm not totally serious. I think we have an opportunity, but we must be very, very careful. And I think it was great how this morning, in several of the sessions, but for instance in the talk of Cristiano and the talk of Fabio, then it was made clear of the responsibility that we have. And just one comment about all the talks is about Cristiano. Cristiano said Oliviero has the optimism of will, represents the optimism of will. I really took the talk of Cristiano as an optimistic talk, because in order to do something, first thing is to assess them, to understand them. And Cristiano emphasized what are some of the very important problems which we should take a responsibility for. Okay, sorry about that. Now, sorry, before getting over, just the first thing I want to say is the sad thing, then it will be hopefully fun. So I want to remember people that are not with us, Ilenia, Emanuele, Marco. There are other people, these were the closest to us, to my group and so, and other people that left us when they were already away from here, Stringa, the founder, Gianni Lazzari, who was vice director when I was director, the president, Fabio Ferrari, I come back to Fabio Ferrari then, Bruno Kessler, that I had the opportunity to meet. And so with us in these days, we had five speakers from abroad, and we felt that the sixth one was also with us, which is Chuck Rich, that left us the beginning of this year. Okay, let's go. So, parlo in italiano adesso, scusate, e vorrei ringraziare, quando si diventa vecchi si sa che si pensa più al passato, la memoria è più rivolta al passato che al passato vicino, quindi cito solamente nei ringraziamenti, non cito le collaborazioni e tutto quello che è successo nell'ultimo tempo, ma quello che è successo all'origine, e quindi ringrazio Carola e Nadia, che sono state delle collaboratrici eccezionali, e lo sono ancora, ma insomma io adesso ricordo il passato. Poi Carola, I think that also the foreigners here have... Then I would like to thank the remaining people. I think I thank only people that are here at Hearst, more or less. So the remaining people of the original group, several people worked in the group, but from the beginning we have still Alberto, Bernardo, Carlo and Fabio. So thanks to them, and that's been great. Well, one thing I would like to say, aside of the sad moment that I mentioned just before, what has been the most difficult moment for me here? Most difficult moment was at the beginning, the first year I was here. I was in charge of the Natural Range Group, and we had some quarrels among us, and this was very tough. And instead, when I had quarrels with the president, director, or whatever, it was much, much easier. True. Okay, then the second reinforcement. Here we have Elena and Massimo that joined quickly after, and all the many colleagues at IRST from the old days. I cannot mention people. It has been a pleasure to work with people of such quality, and all people that helped in the big enterprise, again, the old times. We have here Tullio Grazioli, who was human resources director. Oh, I was speaking Italian before. Okay, abbiamo Tullio Grazioli, che era direttore del personale ai tempi di Stringa, e l'ho conosciuto bene poi quando abbiamo selezionato persone insieme e quando abbiamo organizzato eventi. Lui è stato fantastico, per esempio, quando abbiamo organizzato la NLP nel 1992, ti ricordi? E Tonini is not here, Tonini non ha avuto esattamente lo stesso ruolo, ma insomma Tonini è stato l'istituzione per molto tempo. Vorrei ringraziare il presidente dell'AI, che è stato veramente fondamentale per noi, l'abbiamo sentito vicino per i 15 anni quasi in cui è stato presidente della provincia. Un episodio solo, voglio dire, se ricordo bene, secondo ciclo, seconda volta, che quando è stato riconfermato insomma presidente la prima volta, lui ha messo, no, this I should say, ok, say it in Italia, ha messo al primo posto della sua campagna elettorale la ricerca, e la cosa divertente e incredibile del Trentino è che l'hanno votato. I was saying about President Delay, who was the president of the region of the autonomous province, and who put at the first place of the electoral campaign at one point research. Have you ever heard something like that? And he was even elected then. Then Bovicini, Delay, and Zanotti, and I'd like to vorrei ringraziare pubblicamente Fernando Guarino, tutti lo conoscete, è stato una presenza costante per noi all'IRST, io posso dire fin dai tempi di Stringa, proprio dal giorno 1, ma soprattutto è stato di supporto negli anni difficili in cui non solo c'era l'inverno dell'AI, ma c'era l'inverno dell'IRST, ci dimentichiamo di questo, periodo dopo la cacciata di Stringa, praticamente finché è diventato presidente della provincia dell'AI. Fernando ci è stato vicino anche in quegli anni, e qualche volta ci ha dato degli stimoli eccessivi che non siamo stati in grado di seguire, però credo che molte cose dobbiamo a Fernando, incluso il dire, beh, dobbiamo cogliere l'occasione per organizzare questo evento. Prima di dirlo è stato Fernando. Of course I learned a lot from many people in this room. Now I cannot spend too much time, but I'd like to mention again once that I drank milk from Gigina, metaphorically, of course. This was in Pisa. It was a great opportunity I had in Pisa. And then it happened that in Pisa, aside learning everything about everything that I learned, so just a little part of artificial intelligence in Pisa, I met Amedeo and Giacomo and other colleagues, Lorenzo and Irina, and we worked together on parsing for several years. Then, and I learned a lot about language from them, from Giacomo, as he mentioned before. Then Cristiano, he was in Rome with the Institute of Psychology, and has been a wonderful period, and I learned a lot about, a lot for me, but very little from what Cristiano knows about many, many aspects of cognition. And when I came here, so it was a challenge, and I had some reference points. At the beginning, one person that was a reference for me, as thinking that I was to direct a sizable group, I had this opportunity from Stringa. So a reference, I mean, you have a high reference, you try to do something, was the former director of Instituto Psicologia, who passed away just shortly before, Lello Misiti. I said he had the right style. Soon after I was here, I started the group project, and then I'll say a couple of words about Alfresco shortly. I was very much inspired by Barbara for what she did at SRI with the team project. And of course, all the wonderful work on dialogue. Candy, they had the famous article. I think it's one of probably the most cited article in natural language processing of 1986 on the ACL Journal. And Wolfgang, who was putting together a complex project. It was not the style. Aside of the team project, it was not the style in our field. And shortly after, I think he was really, I think, the first one with multimodality. And I mean, we immediately joined here. It was a big inspiration for me. There is also, I'll say it now, there is also the knowledge representation part that was very popular in Italy with the Kelwan approach that was reported this morning. And so also this was a part of this complex endeavor. So language at the time for us had to be together with knowledge representation. And Enrico must be here somewhere. Where is Enrico? Didn't mention Enrico before because I said I mentioned only people that are still here. But he was the knowledge representation guy. Okay, I learned from many other people, but let's move. Pictures, you want to see pictures. Okay, parliamo italiano. Allora, questo è Stringa, quello è Grazioli. E poi ci sono alcune persone che potete riconoscere. In ultima fila, alla vostra alla vostra destra c'è Alberto con Marco Ponzi e Sandro Zorat che è qua da qualche parte. Ecco, altri sono andati, mi pare. Questo era abbastanza agli inizi. Ok, I want to say, I should say a couple of jokes. So, com'è? Sì, che se ne parlava. Vabbè. Allora, dice about the beginning. I hope it will be relevant to what I want to say. There is this computer science that works, and a frog comes there and says, "Kiss me, I will become a princess." So he takes the frog up and put it in his pocket. After a while, he hears this voice again. Takes it out. "Kiss me, I will become a princess." Back in. One third time, same thing. "Kiss me, I will become a princess." Takes it out and says, "Look, I'm a computer scientist. I don't have time for girls. But the frog that speaks is cute, so I keep you with me." So, not literal, I wouldn't say that it was literally like this here, but we worked hard. We worked in the night without Grazioli knowing. We jumped over the fence to come here to work in the night. I mean, you know the joke about the lottery? Probably you know it. This is an old Jewish joke, but most of people don't know it, so I will tell. There is this very pious person, very poor, and he says, he prays God, "Look, I'm so poor, please let me win the lottery." Next, when is it? Friday, I don't know. The draw, nothing happens. So 1 week passes, and then again, "Look, I have always been so faithful and pious, and I have 7 children. Please let me win the lottery." Again, there is the draw, and nothing happens. So the next week, he becomes a bit angry, I should say. "Look at me, please let me win the lottery." And you hear a big thunder. And then a deep voice from above that says, "Meet me halfway, buy a ticket." And in fact, it was really, for several of us, was really risk-taking coming here. We didn't know if the place would have succeeded or not. Then today the situation is totally different. So, should I speak in Italian a bit? Okay. Io all'inizio, appunto, sono stato preso per mettere in piedi il gruppo di linguaggio, ci siamo occupati quindi di vari aspetti di linguaggio, che era la cosa di cui mi ero occupato fino a quel tempo. Questo è il gruppo. All'inizio, non completo, per qualche ragione Fabio era da qualche parte, c'era Vieri in più. Mi dimentico di qualcuno dell'inizio? No, penso che fossimo noi, no? Distinti, come vedete. Questa è la, the famous Parozon picture. Al fresco. Al fresco was really I think it was a modern system for these days, because it was before the web was conceived. Okay, hypertext did exist for a long time, but it tried to put together serious natural language processing, as we were doing at the time, with a fundamental role for dialogue. Knowledge representation, and of course whatever we knew about parsing, and even in the parsing we had, I don't know, idiom parsing, complex thing, plus generation. We were doing serious generation at the time. But the interesting thing is that it put together goal-oriented behavior, which is typical of language, and navigational behavior, which is typical of hypertext exploration. And would be very nice to have something like that with modern technology. Of course, the system was not robust as it was at the time. It was totally different from the technological point of view. But the concept, I think, would be modern. In the web world, to have such a thing would be real, would be very nice. And as I said, for working on that, we were deeply inspired by the people that I mentioned before. Okay, this person, the person that you see at the demo, we did several demos. I will tell you then one episode about the demos, but several demos, and poor Alberto was always working at the demo and trying to hide what did not work. But the person that you see here is the most important person in Italy ever, nearly, more important than the Pope. He was even, they say, I don't know what was the last word, but he was even thought to have connection with the top of the mafia. And when I say mafia, I don't mean academic mafia. Academic mafia is worse, but... Yeah. So, very important demo. Now, the thing that I wanted to mention about the first demo, this was the Alberto may remember this, not with Andreotti. The first demo ever, there was, I don't know, Stringa asked us to give a demo, and the system behaved okay, but then I did the thing that one should never do so easily, at least, to ask the guy, can't remember who he was, do you want to ask something? And he asked the most trivial question. This was about Italian art of the 13th century. So he asked simply, who is Giotto? Who is Giotto? Easy. And you see that the system was working, and was it on the Sun machine probably, or was it on the Liszt machine? Perhaps on the Liszt machine at the time. Okay, yes, here we have the Xerox Liszt machine, so it was on the Liszt machine. And you saw that the system was really sweating, and it was a hard thing to come. Went on and on, I don't know, 1 minute probably. And finally, the answer comes. So, and the answer was, the question was, who is Giotto? The answer comes, and it is Giotto. Which was right, but the system was weak on the pragmatic side of the problem. So this is again Guido Andreotti. This is one of the theses. E qui è Roldano. No, sì, questa è la tesi di Roldano a Milano. Conferences, we organized conferences. This was ANLP in 1992. And you see several people you know here. Stringa, Don Walker, who passed away a few months after this, and Martin Kay, Martin's wife, Iris, Zampoli, who passed away a few years ago. The last one is Nicoletta, I think. Yeah. It was a good conference. This is Lynn Bates, we were from BBN, your colleague. Okay, this is a nice picture at Castellivano. There are many people you know here. Okay. Okay, joke. There is this joke. These are three rabbis, tre rabbini. Lo dico in italiano, forse. No, in inglese. Tre rabbini, coming back from a very, very high level conference on philosophy. These are the most knowledgeable people, high level. And the conference is over. They take, say, New York. They take a taxi to go back to the hotel, the three together. And the first one says, top philosophers. The first one says, I know nothing. Second one then says, I know nothing of nothing. And the third one says, I know nothing of nothing of nothing. Taxi driver is driving, and he says, I know nothing of nothing of nothing of nothing. And the three say, who does he think he is? We had fun. This is Capri, Massimo and Elena with Barbara, who gave a series of lectures at ACAI, the Advanced Course on Artificial Intelligence organized by our colleagues in Naples. Okay, Ferrari. I said this in Italian. Ferrari era stato nominato presidente da poco, mandò via il direttore precedente e disse: nominiamo un direttore interno. Adesso, come vedete in questa foto, Ferrari è una persona in gamba, che aveva tante virtù, però insomma, fra di noi possiamo anche dire, cioè, amava bere un po'. Triestini intendo, ma insomma era mezzo triestino. E allora fatto sta che probabilmente tra i fumi dell'alcol mi ha nominato direttore. E quindi è stato direttore e Mentre prima, a suo tempo, Carol era con me, come direttore, ho lavorato con Nadia, è stato un grande piacere, come si vede un po' da questa foto. Non c'ho una foto con Carola, ma... E questa è una foto con i responsabili di divisione. C'è Gianni Lazzari, Paolo. Quella volta l'IRST comprendeva anche la parte dei microsistemi materiali, quindi c'è Mario, Anderle e Fabio, che appunto era direttore della divisione. Della divisione da cui venivo io. Qui vedete Allegria nella sala, e insomma, sono sicuro che pensiate che fosse perché era la fine del mio mandato, quindi insomma, quando ho chiesto io veramente di smettere, allora sembrano molto allegri per questo fatto, finalmente ce ne siamo liberati. Invece no, forse anche, ma abbiamo portato la musica all'IRST quella volta. Era questo il motivo. Al fresco, qui c'è una foto curiosa di Dell'Ai. Stiamo mostrando, probabilmente questo era qualcosa che aveva a che vedere col sistema di Maurizio Mologo. Di dietro si vede Massimo, con cui abbiamo lavorato insieme su tutte le cose di beni culturali e tante altre. E questo è sempre nella fase conclusiva, the ending phase of al fresco, sorry, of Peach, the name of the system, in which we work jointly with the FKI. And Wolfgang has shown pictures, but this one you didn't show. So it's good. So we are together in this case in Saarbrücken because we had also work developed together with Antonio Kruger in Saarbrücken, and that one is the director of the museum. So it's just one instance of the collaborations that we had with the FKI, which was really a big privilege for us. As I said, we had fun throughout. This was, oh, by the way, perhaps it's the anniversary. Now we are in April, so perhaps this event is to remember the April Fool's Day workshop on computational humor. With Carlo, we worked for many years, and we are working now on these things. Carlo shown this, but a couple of words. This was the most important prize that I ever received. Actually, we didn't receive it. The story is this. There was this popular program on Rai, on the radio, for some popular but intelligent program, I mean, very the cultural program. But they had a certain point, I don't know why, they organized a challenge to come out with the best acronym. And so with Carlo, we said, let's call them. We called the radio and said, we are the fathers of a candidate to participate to this. To father. Yes, I mean, it is an artificial system that produces acronyms. Can it participate to the challenge? And they said yes, and then we won the special prize from the jury. I mean, we won, the system won. And they gave us this. This is in Israel, the starting of the project with Marty. It has been a great opportunity all those years to work with Marty and other colleagues. I think it was very, very a great initiative of President Delay, actually, who decided to fund this collaboration, which is going on until now. This was perhaps the most successful event, at least before this one, we ever had at IRST, which was the chess challenge between the system by Shai Bushinsky, which was world champion, against the best Italian player, Godena. Of course, the system won. But it was with the chess commentators. It was very good to read. This is an opportunity that I had to be seated next to the great writer Aleph Bet Yehoshua in Haifa at the conclusion of the first phase of the project. You see Massimo there? And, this is a bit more recent. Paolo has involved me, to assist him in several capacities. So it was a great opportunity. I'm very grateful for this. And this is with Lorenzo, but I would like to tell a joke here, which is relevant. So, again, the rabbi dies. Jews don't have exactly a clear vision about paradise or hell, or so it's not. It's a bit fuzzy. Anyway, he's somewhere there, and online before him, there is a guy with tattoos, a t-shirt, a golden chain, and seated in front of them is the Archangel Gabriel. We don't have St. Peter, there is the Archangel Gabriel. And as far as we know, there isn't much technology there, so he's checking on a book. And so this guy, in line before this important rabbi, comes there, and the Archangel Gabriel says, name, profession, and he says, I'm a Shapira and a taxi driver in New York. Guy says, wait a moment, I check. He checks. Okay, I find you here. Okay, everything in order. So please get a silk robe and a staff, bastone pastorale, and welcome, say, to paradise in general. Okay, then comes the rabbi and says, well, name, profession, and he says, Abraham Hirschfeld. I was a chief rabbi in the Bet Yaakov congregation for 20 years. And wait a moment, Archangel Gabriel checks. Okay, you are expected here. Okay, a cotton vest and a wooden cane, and please move fast. The rabbi says, wait a moment, there must be a mistake here. I mean, I was important rabbi. The one before me was a taxi driver. And the Archangel Gabriel says, look, here we look at results. When you were speaking, giving your sermons, everybody slept in the synagogue. When the guy was driving, everybody was praying. La traduco, questo è importante, per cui stiamo attenti ai risultati. Ok, se credete che solo a Trento sono diventato così, no, anche prima. Questo è con Cristiano, quello in mezzo è Domenico Parisi, e stiamo festeggiando l'arrivo della List Machine a Roma. Allora, Paolo, mi dai ancora qualche minuto? La fine, dopo la fine dico ancora qualcosa di saggio, quasi. Da un po' di anni ci occupiamo di aspetti collegati al linguaggio creativo, a forme semplici, ma che hanno un effetto in qualche maniera, anche magari dal punto di vista pratico, con qualche piccola alterazione di qualche espressione conosciuta. Il tipo di espressioni è come questo, che è frutto di puro genio a Napoli. Sembra che questa era veramente un'espressione che usavano per promuovere l'obliterazione dei biglietti sugli autobus. Infatti c'è sotto il segno dell'azienda napoletana di mobilità. Di mare qua, è geniale. So, this is a picture that I made in London. If you can read, I find it fantastic, a genius. Per chi non conosce, hummus è un piatto medio orientale che, diciamo, è a base di ceci, cioè, insomma, è sostanzialmente peas. Questo è give peace a chance, conoscete John Lennon, eccetera. E quindi ecco, questo è l'obiettivo. Allora, abbiamo fatto varie cose con Carlo ne ha parlato prima, ma vediamo se si riesce a mostrare due piccoli, proprio due flash di lavoro fatto soprattutto da Lorenzo, che è quello di dietro, che si addottora venerdì. E questo è un sistema per titolare, this is a system for giving automatically a catchy headline. Let's see if it works. I don't know how much it is. Okay, first, from the article, this is a summary of the article. It takes out some important, so to say, concepts. Then it looks for familiar expression, and it provides, was it visible? It provides, anyway, a new headline that evokes the concept there, but is catchy. This is one of the things. Another thing is coming, it's a different project, coming from an article to provide a musical parody of the content of the article, and we experimented if this helps remembering the contents. Oops, should work. Oh, perhaps we can hear something, let's see. The whole process is automatic.
It's been a hard year's fight, and I've been munching like a dog. It's been a hard year's fight, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get...
Okay, we're having fun. By the way...
Hey, thieves.
Okay, there's another one.
don't grin with bad. Take an arm, thief, and grip it better.
So it starts from the news and it produces this thing in music. By the way, now we hope that evaluation of these two systems, which I may show something. Let me see. Yes, the evaluation, we did a long series of evaluations, and we hope this may go through a Teach-Kai, even if it is very, very, very on the sidelines of what AI is now. I would be very pleased, because it would be the 10th paper of mine at Teach-Kai or AAAI at the main conferences. So it would be a round number. Nice. The Mockingbird is the second one. Just quickly. Okay, let's move on. So another theme that we worked at with Fabio and Marco Guerini is ethics and dilemmas, especially connected to persuasion. I think that ethics is very, very important, but now I think I've taken already a lot of your time, so I won't discuss this. So now I get serious. I try to say something serious, something wise. Failures. I think that a big failure for all our field has been the scarce impact on human learning and human development. We would have expected to have a positive impact, and instead, as very well Cristiano especially has pointed out, it wasn't so. And on fundamental research, I think that a cultural failure was to abandon the ambition to link to cognitive science, and in general the ambition to explain things. So, five themes for research for the future. Not only these five, but these five, I think, are important. One is collaboration, and as Cristiano pointed out, not only collaboration, other aspects of social behavior, but I think it's a very, very important theme, especially at a time where artificial agents are part of our society. And the work of Barbara is fundamental in this aspect. Partnership in creativity. Computers can be creative. It's not something that doesn't belong to computers. They can be creative. Reasonably, they can help also human creation. Human creativity, mostly it will be still very difficult for computer program to choose among the different production of their creativity. This is something that for a long while I think will belong to humans. But it's a very interesting field. This group will try to do something about that. Understanding persuasion is a very, very hot topic from all aspects. Defense from unwanted persuasion. Some form of subtle persuasion can be for the good. Can be for the good, not necessarily advertisement. It can be for inducing people to have a better attitude to immigrants, for instance. And not everything is rational. A lot is a matter of attitude, of emotions, of touching the right chord. It turns out that the simple theme of relation to truth is something that should be investigated, because nowadays not only are there fake news, there are fake images. You can do everything and you don't know what is true and what is not true. And I said, perhaps now you can trust just what is in front of you. But even that, for after a while, we'll have such good robots that even that you would not be sure. So this is something to think about and what to do about that. Connected to that, but broad is computational ethics. I think it's time that we don't approach ethics similar to any other disciplines. Biology also medicine have problems of ethics. But here we are unique because the systems that we are developing in the future will have to choose them, not us. Them, they will have to choose in front of new situations, bad from good from bad. So I think that this field is very, very important, and we should devote time to that. So in the end, my wish, I have the general recommendation. Okay, public research is needed. We cannot rely on private funds if we want to address all these. Whatever solution for giving more space and listening to the young, and for the young to follow the advice of Barbara's of yesterday. And as I said, the opportunity of AI is to integrate diverse areas, in primis computer science and cognition, and find technical solution with as an impact useful systems, but also cultural impact. And again, I thank Cristiano for what he said, and Fabio also for what he said at the end of the talks. And so now I am to the wish for the future, which is, of course, further pleasure in research in AI. Thank you.